What is this? Guys, oh my God. Guys, the whatchamacallit just ended. The press conference for Khabib and Conor just ended. And this is my initial reaction. Obviously, you know, I'm a Conor fan, but I'm going for Khabib on this one because I'm also a Khabib fan, and I want both of them to win, but I know it's impossible, so I have to be honest, and yeah, I'm kind of rooting a little bit more for Khabib. But I find myself, as if you're a Conor fan, you know that you find yourself every single time you see Conor, it's like I can't like stop smiling, and just like, you know, he just entertains you so much that it's like, ugh, I want him to like win. At least the press conference or something. And I'm sorry to say, guys, he lost that press conference. 100% lost. The only angle that actually worked for Khabib that he used, and he used many angles. He tried going for his whiskey. He tried going for his manhood. He tried going for Putin. He tried going for his dad. And the only angle that actually worked, in my opinion, was the saying that his dad, you know, was basically the political, that he has a political fear, which is, you know, if you know anything about, you know, the Russians and the Russians from that, you know, I think it's Dagestan, from that area, you know that that's very sensitive because they feel that they were conquered. And it's a whole other story. But that angle, when Conor touched that political and that you're afraid of the political repercussions and brought Putin into it, like you're afraid of Putin or are you disrespecting Putin, that kind of worked. But it was, the moment was so slight that because there was not an audience there, Conor ended up looking crazy. Like Conor looked like he was drugged, like he was drunk, like he was high. And there was no, you know, without the audience, you don't get the same effect from Conorisms, as I call them, you know, because I love them. So yeah, he looked really unhinged. He looked afraid. He looked like he knew he wasn't getting the best of Khabib, and he looked as if he knew that yeah, this is trouble. So out of that press conference, sorry to say, guys, Khabib won, Conor zero, you know what I mean? And as a matter of fact, I guess at this point we're doing Khabib 2, Conor zero, because Khabib ended up winning the whole bus incident too. So, yeah, I'm concerned for even though I want Khabib to win, you know, because I respect, you know, his wrestling so much, and you know, I enjoy watching him. I hate to see Conor lose. I hate it. And at least if I know that he's not going to win the fight, at least to see him win, like, you know, at least in these press conferences would have been enough for me as a fan. But he totally fell flat, guys. He was just promoting this liquor, and he just looked like he's unhinged, like he's on something. And yeah, it did not look good for our Conor. Yeah, this is not good. I don't know what mental state he's in, but whatever it is, everything that's been coming up towards the fight has me, like, you know, doubting, you know, Conor's ability. I mean, I picked Khabib from the start because of the, like, the different styles and how they would match. So, you know, from the start, you know, he was starting at negative to begin with. But all of these other things that are going on with Conor, this is really, really troubling for him. And I just hope that that he straightens out, because if he doesn't, he's going to lose this fight, which I think he's going to lose it anyways, you know, no matter what he does. But I just don't want to lose him completely out of the MMA in the process. You know what I mean? Because MMA wouldn't be the same without Conor. But yeah, I just, Khabib was consistent throughout. And you know what? Besides, I would say probably 30 seconds, he displayed no emotion. He displayed almost like Conor wasn't even there. You know what I mean? So, yeah, that's very, very troubling. That's very, very troubling. we'll see what happens. I mean, I guess overall, anything that happens, I'll be happy. But this is troubling. So I don't know. Let's keep our fingers crossed that, you know, Conor can get himself recuperated and whatever's going on, he can fix. And I don't like that he's drinking and, you know, looking drunk and saying that he was going to the bar and all this stuff, you know, so close to the fight. Yeah, not good, guys. But anyways, let's keep our fingers crossed and see what happens. But right now, Khabib 2, Conor 0. Gotta call it like I see it. Bye, guys.